33 in Hollywood, California. At the time, Charlie Chaplin was doing his third film, and he asked for a band for a bar scene. So we got together for this Charlie Chaplin film back in 1933. It was the younger years of Hollywood. It was a good time. The town was booming, and we were part of the exploding scene.
And also, oh. Okay, you can.
1983 hat es losgegangen. Das ist losgegangen mit den Red Hot Chili Peppers, sondern 1933. Charlie Chaplin hat für seinen vierten Film einen Statisten gesucht und ist so auf sie zurückgekommen. Hollywood war damals groß am Leben und sie natürlich auch. Okay. I mean.
Back when we started with Charlie Chaplin, if you notice, if you look carefully, Jack and I, we both have artificial noses. Yeah, well, Bozo 1 and Bozo 2, we both have fake noses. And that's because when Charlie Chaplin was making that film, The Gold Rush, there's a scene that he does with two forks and the potatoes, and he makes them dance. Well, those potatoes were actually our noses.
Oh, I see. Also, das ist jetzt mal ein echtes Stück Aufklärung. Ihr habt vielleicht bemerkt, dass Bozo 1 und Bozo 2 falsche Nasen haben. Nun, das kommt daher, bei diesem Charlie Chaplin-Film, Gold Rush heißt er, da kennt ihr vielleicht diese Szene, wo Charlie mit einer Gabel und zwei Kartoffeln so einen Tanz macht. In Wirklichkeit waren es keine Kartoffeln, sondern ihre Nasen. Ha, I didn't know that.
I learned how to say "Whoa, Nelly."
Whoa, Nelly. Could you say it?
Whoa, Nelly.
Whoa, Nelly.
This is for the Kinder, right?
This is for the Kinder. This
Hello,
is okay.
Kinder. No, but seriously. That's
the one for Kinder. All right. Good. How about a clip?
A clip?
Yeah, a video clip.
You want to show a video clip?
Yes.
Let's show Fight Like
a Boy. Wait a second. That's getting a little crazy. I know this is a video show and all, but to actually show a video clip?
Yeah.
No.
Fight Like a Brave is a good video. Why we couldn't show it?
If you show it, I'm going to beat the hell out of you.
No, actually, Fight Like a Brave is probably the best video ever made in the entire history of mankind, and I think it's about time we had a look at it, don't you?
You had three different producers in your career.
That's correct.
Andy Gill.
George Clinton and Michael Beinhorn, also known as Michael Schlanghorn.
Yes. How did you get to all these producers? I mean, they're well known. They're, you know, I mean, they're superior producers. Mm-hmm. Isn't it hard to get to people like that?
So well, I can tell you in a brief time capsule summary quotient that we first got Andy Gill because we loved the music that he made with the Gang of Four. He did a record called Entertainment and a record called Solid Gold that we loved and were very inspirational to the Red Hot Chili Peppers. They were hard-edged, hard-rocking, funky soul jams that we got off on heavily. We thought that he'd be a good choice. As it turned out, he wasn't the perfect choice. He had sort of gone limp by the time that we got together with him, and we were still hard, so we ended up with kind of a half staff on a record. Don't worry about it, because then we got together with George Clinton, the master of funk, the true 18-ring leader of a circus, George Clinton, the greatest walking funk master alive today, making some of the most beautiful music ever made, known to mankind. We made a great record with him. The engineer was a little weak. I think he had a nervous breakdown during the mix. The mix fell a little short. Don't worry about it. We got onto our third record. It's called The Uplift Mofo Party Plan with, of course, Michael Beinhorn as the producer. We got good sounds. We had good songs. We had good performances. It was a good mix. It was kind of a nice situation. We kind of liked making the record. We rocked out. We did, okay? That record came together. It's our favorite to date.
But that doesn't really answer my question.
How did we get them?
Yes.
We called them up on the telephone.
Right.
Okay.
Mail order. Vielleicht mitgekriegt. Drei Produzenten haben sie bisher gehabt, die ihre Sache versucht haben. Andy Gill von Gang of Four, da hat es geheißen, ja, also das hat uns gut gefallen, die Musik, was er gemacht hat mit Gang of Four, und wir dachten, er sei das Richtige für uns, aber war er nicht. Und es geht dann weiter mit George Clinton. George Clinton, der Meister aller Rapper, aller Funker überhaupt jemals, das war der Größte überhaupt. Der Mixer hat einen nervösen Zusammenbruch gehabt, einen Nervenzusammenbruch am Pult beim Mischen, und das hat ihn aber auch nicht so gefallen. Es brachte aber doch den Durchbruch, und jetzt geht es weiter eben mit Beinhorn. Beinhorn, den kennt ihr auch, hat viele andere Leute produziert, wie Nona Hendrix und so weiter. Und jetzt auch die Red Hot Chili Peppers. Und die Frage war, wie sind sie an die rangekommen? Ha, sie haben ihn angerufen.
I'd like to tell all the little kids, don't worry, if you get to be about 12 or 13 and you're still wetting the bed or you haven't gotten any pubic hair yet, Don't worry, because I wet the bed until I was 14.
16.
Okay, and I didn't really start getting any noticeable pubic hairs until I was about 17.
22.
So don't mind.
Okay, also das ist eine echte Nachricht für Bettnässer. Die gibt's ja auch. Er sagt, ihr sollt euch keine Sorgen machen, wenn er mit 12 immer noch ins Bett macht. Er hat's mit 14, er sagt 16 gemacht. Und es ist völlig in Ordnung. Aus ihm ist ein wirklich gutes Mitglied der Gesellschaft geworden. I think it's time for another clip.
Time for another clip. One second.
Clip.
Clip.
Jungle Man.
Clip. Clip. It's time for a clip.
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 Who's going to be the next president of the United States?
I pray every night that it'll be Jesse Jackson.
Jesse Jackson?
Yes. I would gladly cut off my left testicle if Jesse Jackson could become the next president.
Also Jesse Jackson meint, er wird der nächste Präsident der Vereinigten Staaten. Er würde gern seinen linken Hoden dafür hergeben, aber so genau will ich das gar nicht wissen. I mean, that's okay. Is the Red Hot Chili Pepper a political band? Politically concerned?
Well, I mean, as people, we definitely have political interests, just because, you know, we live on the world and the entire, you know, planet is very vulnerable to the politics of certain nations, and we happen to live in one of those nations, America. And, you know, unfortunately, we have the president of Ronald Reagan right now, and we really hate his guts, and we'd be much better off as a race as a whole if he was dead. And it's a shame that he didn't die when the attempted assassination took place. But hopefully his legacy will die when he gets out of office.
Das ist ein hartes Statement. Ich habe Sie gefragt, ob die Red Hot Chili Peppers eine politische Band sind. Nein, als Band nicht, aber als Person wohl, als Menschen, als Personen. Sie sind besorgt um das, was so vorgeht in Ihrem Land mit Präsident Reagan. Was er genau über ihn gesagt hat, das möchte ich eigentlich nicht übersetzen. Aber Sie wären froh, wenn er nicht da ist. Deshalb eben Jesse Jackson.
We're also severely anti-racist. And we're also very anti-industrial pollution or any other kind of pollution for that matter. And we would like very much for companies like Shell Oil and Burger King to leave the rainforest alone, because the planet needs those rainforests, and so do the people, and so do the animals. And we just, we wish that that Botha would die, because all the people in South Africa deserve to be free just as much as I am free. And I wish that that could be so. So let it be said that we wish that could be so.
And Shell Oil is not the ones who support the process.
Just let me get that over. Also es entwickelt sich hier zu einem politischen Statement sozusagen. Red Hot Chili Peppers sehen sich durchaus als besorgte Band, auch was so Natur betrifft. Sie kanzeln einige Großfirmen ab, die sie nicht hier sehen wollen. Auch sind sie antirassistisch, das möchten sie an dieser Stelle auch mal sagen. Auch sind sie gegen Botho und Südafrika. Also eine ganze Palette, die sich da so mitschwingt und die sich so offensichtlich gar nicht zeigt. Why doesn't this show in your music?
It does. If you look very carefully, there are several statements and even song titles that shows up in. You have to dig deep, you have to look deep, you have to read deep into the lyrics. In fact, there's one lyric that says specifically...
Why do we do it because the president's a whore?
Why do we do it because the president's a whore?
We are in the position to sell the ammunition. What the fuck is the American tradition?
So. Die Frage war, warum sich das nicht mehr zeigen würde in ihren Texten und in ihren Aussagen. Das ist aber nicht der Fall, heißt es, weil es zeigt sich durchaus, es ist durchaus sichtbar. Man muss ein bisschen tiefer gehen, ein bisschen genauer auf die Texte hören. Zwischen all den Fucks und so weiter ist doch eine ganz handfeste Aussage.
Every night, every day.